Today on RH More Works, we're going to put this bad boy together, and Kristin and I are taking over.
So before we assemble, we want to make sure that we have all the pieces that we need for the frame and that all the holes are chased with a tap.
So we're going to take the frame and then assemble with the swing arm and the rear shocks with the rear fender. And we'll assemble the rear brake and chain guard.
Alright, so we're going to start by greasing up this bolt. You want to put the bolt in this way?
Yep. Sorry if I'm
blocking. There you go. And then push it in. Should be okay.
I think it's all that.
There we go. Got that assembled. And then we can tighten this down a little bit. I got three right tools. It's a 14mm like 17 on the other side. You want to try ratcheting over on this side? Sure. I'm going to wait until I get on my side here. Okay. So we just tighten it up just to make it snug for right now. We can probably get our torque specs and torque it up later on. Okay, so our next step is to take these rear shocks and assemble them onto the frame.
Let's take this piece off and I'll lightly grease it. Just regular grease.
Go grease it.
Well, my hands are a little greasy already, so can't. It's coming. It's all good. I got it.
Don't worry.
We're all good. Now that this is greased, I'm going to put the one shock on and then feed it through.
On the nut and washer here. No, maybe not. Hands are creasy as well. And then all these we already kind of figured out, these are all 14 millimeters. That worked out, come on.
Obviously not so much.
Good?
Good.
Alright.
Well, these guys.
Yeah. Now I got a ratchet wrench. Like I said, we'll figure out what the torque specs are with those and torque those down. So that concludes this section for right now, and we're going to move forward on to the fender.
So here we are, we've got the fender. We're going to be attaching it at the top first, and then we'll be attaching the lower section.
Okay. These are 10 millimeter stock steel you use for the top. Those just kind of hand tighten for right now. Yeah, and do the rear and the bottom. Yeah, that one's cool. fenders on there. We're going to move on to, okay, so now we're going to work on the chain guard. We've got already the hardware in here, so we're going to take that out. You want to tighten it?
No.
Thank you. You're welcome.
To be putting the forks into the chassis and attaching the two together. We'll be starting by greasing up the bearings, and then we'll attach the stem into the headpiece here. So, do the honors of greasing?
Yeah.
I guess I could grease this one while you're greasing that, huh?
I'm just kind of dabbing around here on the bearings. It's kind of messy.
Just a little bit.
Good. Your art project over there?
Yeah, it's kind of like a painting, but with a twist, you know? Just without the alcohol.
Not that bad, then.
I mean, this piece does twist kind of right. That's what the bearings do.
Yeah. Okay.
In layman's terms. With my greasy hands, just so we can make some marks on the beautiful paint job.
It's already greased up everywhere else. Get the cap. Okay. either.
They said I might be helpful, but I don't know. Kind of doubting that at this point. It's been fun though. Tightened enough for now, then we'll be able to work it a little bit more later.
Okay, so next up we're going to put the top plate on and secure that. Use our 14 millimeter socket and use those. You can go ahead and tighten it on there if you like. Do you have it on for tightening or for loosening?
Good question.
What's happening? Is it loosening or is it tightening?
Like it's just moving around a lot.
I'm going faster. I'm only going
quite
I'm
possibly.
Almost one.
Yep.
I'm done.
Pretty sure I did this wrong. But it's tight.
Alright, let's see. And then we're going to put on the washer too, on the stem, top of the plate. This is a 30. And put on the washer and the nut. Use an extension so I don't Hit this pan here. Everything's all snug and tightened up. Okay.
Well done, not messing up that beautiful paint job.
I tried. And that's it for putting this together. Okay, so now we're going to work on the front fenders. Take off the hardware that's already on here. Tighten this up?
I'll leave that for you.
Okay.
I'm not touching the paint.
Oh, okay. Fenders on there secured.
Looks great.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going to take this rear tire and put it onto the subframe.
And we're going to need another couple hands helping us.
Okay. Just give me 1 second. If you can help me, Kristin, and grease up the axle there, and I'll grease up this push and this spacer.
You guys need any other help, like putting it together?
No, we're good. Thanks, though.
Sure.
No, bro.
Am I doing a good job holding it?
No.
Yeah, it hasn't fallen over yet.
I got a no and a yes, so I'm so confused.
Well, it's like 50-50, right?
That still means I lose.
It's all greased up when you're ready.
Okay. I'm probably gonna need some help.
Of course.
A little all greased up. All this. Yeah. Okay. Get this all situated and then you can put the axle in.
Perfect.
You got it up there?
You good?
Almost. Yeah.
Go behind the bike and then film this.
Turn like this way?
This way.
This way. I'm putting this one first, right?
Yep.
Putting together the rest of the setup on the other side.
Okay.
So are you gonna...
You want me to keep this? It goes through the hole here?
Yeah. As long as you got that secured.
Is it hiding in the anchor?
What?
The trussing on there? I don't want that, right?
You got it?
Yep.
I'd say you guys did a lot.
Making progress.
You built the whole thing, man.
Fine by me. I just want to write it after Kristin does, because you guys put it together.
I'm the dummy.
We'll wrap you in bubble wrap. You'll be fine.
Thanks. I'm molding it.
But like, are you like, you like you're moving?
You're
not even holding it.
You're making me move.
I was just told to hold this. Am I allowed to do something else?
Yeah, you can move it.
Yeah.
I said you can move it. That doesn't mean let it go.
Sure.
Help me, since you're on that side, to see.
You can put the axle in from that side, Kristin, and get started.
Okay. So yeah, we didn't need your hot front bar. Front bar down just a little bit.
I'm gonna make sure that tab is in there.
I got the tire clip.
Is this only one way?
Yeah, I got the tire.
This over, Carrie, so she can have room to move.
Wait, towards me?
Get the fork leg out of the way of the spacer. There you go, now she has room to work. Make sure it's seated on that tab, Kristin. Pull the wheel toward you, Kristin. There you go. Now, Carrie, line up your side.
Okay.
And then feed the axle through. Line up, Carrie?
Line up on it, sir.
Okay, you can use the mallet, Kristin.
There it goes. There you go.
Okay.
Sweet, and we're still in.
Now you can get the nut and washer on that side.
You got that, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah, it can come down now. You got that side?
Yep. Alrighty.
Almost done.
This thing looks pretty sweet.
It's really cool. It's a nice looking bike.
I know, it's a paperweight and there's no engine.
It's just the downhill model.
I don't know how you're gonna ride it without a seat.
Yeah.
I don't know how you're gonna ride it without an engine.
Yeah.
It's too much power.
When you're going downhill, you just put your feet up.
Do you want to spin it?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Good job, guys.
Yeah, thanks for the help.
Anytime. Well, the inside ate a sandwich or something.
Yeah, okay.
Don't forget to save us some.
Okay. That concludes us putting everything together for the day. Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, thanks for watching.